Oh dear lord, you are so laggy and off. It's really like, what? But how? How do I mouth? Oh my god. Alright, anyways, we should have a little conversation, because I've had a lot of people asking about cosplay contest judging.
Ooh,
and
I know about that.
You and I have both done it. In fact, that's how you and I met. So, I don't know, take a second, introduce yourself, do whatever. Know that any F-bombs that you put in there, I will probably bleep with Mario sounds. So.
That's fair. If I do Mario sounds, can you put F-bombs in?
I mean, we have the technology. That'd be a hell of a video. It works for Pulp Fiction.
I have a... No, never mind. I thought I had a Pulp Fiction poster up here. Never mind,
you
I don't.
You have a Scarface one, so...
I have Scarface, and I've got a Kill Bill one right back there.
All right, I'm going to shut up, and you can do your thing. You can tell I'm going to shut up, because I'm going to drink this.
All right.
Go.
Oh, Jesus. My girlfriend used the sink for a sec. I can't tell if you heard that. One sec. She's cooking. She's good. All right. My name is Bronsoon Cosplay, aka Bronsoon Cosplay Tattoos and Doodles. I'm a tattoo artist and a cosplayer. I've been cosplaying for, I don't know, 5-ish years? It's hard to pinpoint because I just am too lazy to look on my Facebook feed and remember when it was exactly. But yeah, I've judged to 3 cosplay contests. One of them was Calgary Expo, and then 2 of them were FanCon and Prince George. And I met Lane when I was judging him at Calgary.
Yeah, and you were judging with who else at Calgary? incredibly intimidating panel.
I had won a contest to go to Calgary for free. It was like a cosplay contest online with votes and stuff. So I won, and I got like a free trip there and stuff, but I also got to judge the cosplay contest there with Jessica Negri, Yaya Han, Akagio Cosplay, I hope I said that right, and Ivy, or is it Ivy Doom Kitty? Ivy Doom.
Yep.
Yeah.
So, like, the cream of the crop of, like, judges and cosplay stuff.
It was
I know, I was, like, right. I was, like, freaking out, it's like, oh dear lord, like, what am I gonna do? Why am I doing this?
Yeah, it was pretty intimidating to, like, sit next to them and be like, I need to say something that is pertinent to the conversation. I like that color! It's a good color!
Red was the good one! Good one, Red!
it was nuts.
And then I've judged, I'm gonna be judging at FanCon, and I've judged at AnimeThon, Taste of AnimeThon, a couple of lower ones around Edmonton and that, so, and hoping to do more and more. So, yeah, I figure that between the two of us, we should be able to come up with at least, you know, one person, you know, one proper person's worth of stuff that we can kind of, you know, tell people. Because I've had a lot of people asking, it's like, well, what do they do? What do they look for? And I just kind of want to give everyone a little bit of a inner sanctum type look. So, I don't know, if there was like one thing, like to get right into it, if there was like one thing that you had to tell everybody in terms of like how to, like, I don't know. Name one thing that you would say, like, the most important part about just cosplay contest judging, I guess.
This is hard, because a lot of people ask me this question, but especially since I live in Williams Lake, which isn't, like, a huge cosplay town, when they ask about cosplay contests, they want to know what it actually is. Mm-hmm. They're like, what, do you just, like, get dressed up or something? Or, like, there's portions to it, right? So I guess the important thing is knowing what you're getting into. A lot of people don't realize that there is like a portion on stage where you do a skit or like whatever you're going to do. A lot of people don't realize that. So I guess one of the more important things is to know what you're getting into. Maybe watch a few examples on YouTube sort of thing. That's what I would say is a very important one that not a lot of people understand. One person at FanCon that I know of, he's like, he entered the cosplay contest and then he did the pre-judging, which is a thing that not a lot of people know. And then he came up to me after. He's like, hey, what's this thing that they're talking about we're going to be on stage? And do I need, what's this music that I need? And I was like, oh god, that's about in an hour. You need to get it together. Turned out all right.
That's the one thing I want to see. Like, I'm excited, as like, especially as FanCon in particular is growing, because I'm like, I want to see more and more skits. I like those things.
Yeah,
because there are some conventions that they'll have like separate awards for skits entirely.
I think that's
which I like. I kind of like that. It's like, you know, you'll have people that, you know, have bad costumes and as if there's any such thing as a bad costume. Like, you know, like, there'll be people that it's like, oh yeah, you bought your costume? Cool. Like, you can still do a skit, and you should be able to. Like, that's the whole point. Like, I think I did another video where I was saying, like, I don't know, I was doing some stuff on cosplay contests, and I never liked the term contest as much. I know in the States they call them masquerades, so it's more of a, like, hey, this is, like, showcasing type thing, so...
That makes sense. I like masquerade a little more than contest. Contest implies that they're losers, and really, we're all losers in cosplay.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
We're all a bunch of dorks who get dressed up and go to comic conventions. That's fine, I love it. But, yeah, you're already losing slash winning by being there, being surrounded by that. So there's no real, like... I don't think a lot of people are bummed when they don't get the grand prize at a cosplay contest. You're just jazzed to be there in the first place. It's a lot of fun.
I mean, there are definitely some. Like, I mean, I know some people that do that, and it's thankfully fewer and far between type thing. And I guess I get it. Like, you know, yeah, you want to win, but I don't know. It's you try to win, and that's not the whole point type thing. But
yeah.
Anyways,
getting it is just to win. You're...
Yeah, then it's just like okay, like I don't know. So you said you were talking about prejudging. So let's talk about that and kind of what that entails for the uninitiated.
All right. Do you want to explain or should I explain it? Or what's the
deal? I think I just said for you two, so for the sake of like continuity, we'll do it that way. Plus, people are sick of hearing me talk on my videos, so I'm just here to like feed you.
I do have a great voice for almost nothing.
A wonderful soprano.
Oh, is the cat puking? Oh, come on, get outside. 1 sec, the cat's puking. I had to throw the cat outside so he'd puke outside. It was a wet one? Oh, we dodged a bullet. It was a wet puke.
Oh, good. Yeah, if you want to see pictures, like, comment, and subscribe, and we will...
I hope you're going to cut this down so it's not just like, hey,
you clearly haven't seen my videos. I'll probably put like some epic like Nightwish music in there and just slow-mo you running away or something like that.
Oh, he's puking!
Oh, is the cat puking?
Okay, prejudging.
Prejudging.
What about it?
So prejudging is basically when, for a cosplay contest, the first half, it's not on stage, it's with the judges. If you're a contestant, you'll go in, you'll meet them, they'll examine your costume, they'll probably ask you a bunch of questions, they'll write down some notes on some cards. Basically, they're looking to see your costume up close, see how it's made, see if there's any like obvious flaws. And by flaws, I mean they're judging like, oh, how did they stitch this? Oh, that looks like it's going to fall apart on stage. Maybe we should tell them.
Which sometimes happens.
It happens, and that's all right.
Yep.
Basically, yeah, prejudging is just the actual judging. It's the first half of the judging. It's basically just your cosplay and how it's made and how you put it all together.
And that takes about how long, then?
Oh, for the individual person or for like as a judge, how long does it take?
Well, I think, weren't you stuck there for like 3.5 hours or something like that when you were doing it last year?
This one was nuts.
Yeah.
As in the novice category, it was like three, like we saw like the two lines, like, wow, there's a lot of experts, that's good, I'll be out of here, like, you know, early enough so that I can go get something to drink, because I have to pee, I have to go, I'm thirsty and I have to pee. And then it turns out, no, the big line was for the novice category that I was.
Yeah, I know, that's one thing, like, I know a lot of people have even told me, it's just like, oh man, we should have longer with each judge for prejudging. It's just, you know, if it's five minutes per person and there are 50 of you, there's, I don't know, a lot of minutes, and yeah, I don't know. Like, yeah, some of ours, it's usually like 2 minutes, although sometimes we'll go to three, and, you know, you'll spend more on sometimes, and like, it is what it is. It's not like I've never been at one. I don't know if you have, but it's like I've never been at one where it's like, all right, go, and it's like a time like that almost be more intimidating. I don't know.
It depends, I think, a little bit on how you present yourself there. If you go when you're like, hey, my name is this. This is my costume. This is how I made it. This is the part that I like, and I did this part here. If you like know all the points to hit right away, your section will usually be shorter because they don't have to ask you a lot of questions because you've hit all the key points. Whereas if you go up and you're like, hey, what's up? They're like, okay, what's your costume? How did you make it? What is this? Then it'll be a little bit longer.
So then what are some of these key points then? because, hey, if it speeds it up for judges, I'm good for that too. But it's also probably good that people know, hey, these are kind of what the judges might actually ask you. So what are these key points that you've seen?
That's fair. Most of how I learned how to judge came from Yaya Han. She was really, really nice when I had to learn how to judge in like 20 minutes.
Like right away, yeah.
Things that she asks and things that I ask. The main important one, I guess, that I ask is, oh, here's the cat. You better not have any puke on you. God, oh, there's the cat.
No!
Minion! Minion's gonna go viral!
Dear Lord, it looks scared.
Yeah. Yep, that's the face.
That's fine, I'm just coughing and knocking my thing off. It's fine.
I thought you were yelling at someone. Well, and important things that Jesus, I'm trying to get this cat out of the frame. The important thing that I always ask is, what are you most proud of that you've made on this? Which I think is cool, because then if you ask people that, they start to get excited, then they'll explain more things about their costume without you having to prod them along.
Like, do that early on and just be like, because I know a lot of people, they'll go in and it's just like, you know, like, tensed up nerves. So it's kind of like, all right, like, hey, what's the best, what are you proud of? Like, just kind of puts people at ease, I would imagine, too.
Exactly. Other things that they ask usually are, how long did this take to make? What materials did you use? What mediums did you use? A lot of judges are really impressed by people who use mixed stuff, like fabric and leatherwork and chainmail and foam. Which is pretty terrible, because pretty much all I do is foam.
I was gonna say, do you have anything but foam? It's foam and paint, it's fine.
Foam, glue, and paint, yeah, what's up? There's some elastic in here. But
yeah, there might be, I don't know. Is hot glue and glue a different thing?
But yeah, they like to know how long you took. It's always really cool if you can show them something. Every judge that I've ever met with my... Dang it, my Gypsy Danger costume isn't here.
It's fine. We'll put some pictures or stuff on there. I don't know. We'll figure it out.
They all love the chest piece. The arc reactor is a steamer that I bought from Savon.
Like
so
a colander. Yeah.
It's just a colander, and I've got that from someone else who was building it online. They were like, "Hey, I used a colander." I'm like, that's so smart. I'm going to do it now. But so if you're looking for like shortcut ways to impress some judges. They really love it when you take ordinary objects and somehow incorporate them into your costume.
Yeah, like, wasn't there in Prince George 2 years ago, wasn't there, like, one costume that was, like, mostly made out of, like, milk cartons or milk jugs or something like that?
Like, cardboard. Yeah, it was a Predator costume, I believe.
Yeah, that was it, right? I think he got, like, second or third place, whatever it was, so.
Hey, the second place the first year of FanCon.
Right. And yeah, like, definitely, yeah, like, having all the materials and all that. How much does, like, the... I don't know. How much does the... How long does this take? Because now I think about it, I've had a lot of people actually ask me that when I've gone up, and it's like, oh, I never actually thought how much that actually has a bearing on how well you score, I guess, for lack of a better term. This is kind of more of an interesting thing. My hair is right in my mouth. Okay, good.
For me, it's an interesting thing because, just because you built it in, like, 4 days doesn't mean you can't win. You know what I mean? Yeah. Doesn't mean that it's not impressive. It's an interesting, and I think, I guess it's, a lot of times it's a dedication thing to see how into it you are.
Right.
I mean.
I don't know, like, sometimes, like, it's just, hey, I'm just interested. Like, yeah. I'm judging, I'm like, I just kind of want to know. Like.
Yeah, a lot of times when I ask it, it's because, like, how long did it take you to build? Because it would take me, like, 6 months. They're like, 2 months. Like, get wrecked.
I know. Mine's usually like, it's like about 13 to 16 months. Like, I did this in a weekend. I'm like, I hate you. Like,
oh, no, well,
I'm making a sport car right now, and I want to tear up my head because I, like, this shouldn't take long. These cost $8 at Value Village. Why is this taking me this many days? But that's fine. What about, like, other questions that, like, you know, like the Negris and the Yayas and all that? Like, what kind of questions have you heard them ask?
I can't remember who asked it, but I always ask now is, what's your mobility like? I always ask it out of interest because all of my costumes are usually, like, really big and, like, hard to get around in. So I like to see other people's mobility so that I can steal those ideas if they're really good for mine. But also, if you made a really nice costume and you can still move like a regular human, that's super impressive.
Yeah.
I can't sit down in most of my costumes.
It's almost more painful for me to sit down at some. Like, that's why I'm liking that I have a bunch that are normal clothings now. It's kind of like, what's your costume? It's a fleece sweater.
It's a gray.
Oh, man. So what about, like, in terms of actually, like, scoring and figuring out, like, okay, we have, like, we only have a prize for, like, one person in novice, let's say. So, like, how are you going, like, how do you guys as judges figure out it's going to be, like, this person versus this person? Like, those tough kind of, you know, those things that we all hate to do as judges. So, like, I don't know, they're both good, and, like, one is, like, so very, like, varyingly different from the other, and I don't know, how do you deal with that?
It is the worst, and when it's really trite to say when you go on stage, it's like really like cliche, like it was so hard to choose, but it like super is hard to choose.
Yep.
I don't, scoring's hard because I don't actually, it's gonna sound terrible coming from a judge, but I don't like believe in scoring cosplays. Like, I don't believe in giving them like a number.
Here's your five on creativity or something. Yeah.
Yeah. I can't remember which contest it was, but they gave you little sheets and they had like a little number scoring system there. And I think it was Yaya was like, oh, I don't ever use numbers for it. You know what I mean? So my scoring system is more, I just write down notes about them, like little shorthand notes. And whatever sticks out to me the most is the one that I guess that I'm like, okay, this is the one I'm going to go with. Because just by being in a cosplay contest, you already have got my vote. You know what I mean? So.
And it's, yeah, like, totally agree with the whole, like, I don't know, it's, you know, and sometimes it's almost like it's, hey, if this would happen on a different day, or maybe I noticed a thing, like, 2 minutes is a hard amount of time to actually compare, you know, hundreds or thousands of hours of people's work. And I think that's kind of why it's like, hey, guys, like, you know, I've known people that have competed in the same costume 3 times, because they never won the first 2 times, and it's, you know, like, it just kind of happens, like, and different people look for different other stuff, so.
Yeah, it's hard. I guess what it is, especially when it comes down to, like, the end when you've, like, usually, at FanCon, for example, I think that we had, like, 3 winners on ours or something like that, I can't remember.
Yeah, I think it was, like,
something
like that.
And then, and 2 runners-up or something like that, so basically we all got to choose one person, I guess, so each judge... I guess it comes down to each judge looks for different things.
Yeah.
So it's really up to personal taste at that point. But when we get into arguments, I call it arguments. So once or twice we've done like rock, paper, scissors to see who's going to win an argument. But in the middle of it, you know, like as you're doing the last like scissors or whatever, you know who should win by that point, because you leave it up to chance for a second, and then you're like, okay, no, wait, I know who it is. It's like flipping a coin when you need to make a really big decision, and as it's like flying in the air and about to land on your arm, you're like, oh yeah, I should pay my rent. That's what I should do. I should not go
you
to the
take
top
the coin and throw it away and just like whatever. I don't need you, two-faced coin.
But yeah, exactly.
Have you ever experienced? I don't know if you have or not, but so cosplay contests often, not always, but often will have like, you know, novice, journeyman, masters, or something like that. Who the hell is texting me? Whatever. What was I saying? Yeah, they'll have like novice, journeyman, masters type thing, and like they have different criteria in terms of that. And I mean, it really depends on the con, but you know. Getting off the point here, have you ever experienced someone getting pushed up a category? Like a novice that, you know, signed up as a novice and then got moved into journeyman or journeyman into masters or something like that?
I haven't personally because, I have no reason why, but I always assumed it was because that's the kind of stuff gets sorted out beforehand. They get to the judges. I always assume that there's like a guy maybe who's like, okay, you've got to move up a category or something like that. But I've always just said, like, because the criteria is always, like, really weird. It's like, have you had 5 years experience and also have won another contest? Then you should be in the Masters or whatever. Yeah. But it's like, well, then that's, like, one person maybe in the province by that criteria, you know what I mean?
Or it's like, have you won this many of this kind of awards, but these awards don't count, and it's like,
it's a little hard. I would say just go with whatever you feel comfortable with.
Yeah.
You know?
I usually say it's like, I know, I haven't judged when I've seen someone get knocked up. That sounds bad, but I haven't judged when I've seen someone get knocked up. But, I know it's happened, and I mean, I guess it very well could have happened before I judged. Now I think about it, I wouldn't have known, but it's, you know, I know I've told, like, I've had some people that got actually, like, bumped up from novice to journeyman and then didn't win in journeyman, and they were kind of salty about it. And I was kind of like, dude, you got jumped, you got bounced up by the judges a category. That's kind of a win. Like,
yeah. take that to heart. That's fine. Yeah. That's a good thing.
It's like, that's better than the, you know, $50 gift card at, you know, Amazon or whatever the prizes are type thing. Like, and it's, yeah, like, it's definitely like, you know, be easy, be good with it. So what about, like you said, there's the stage component. What kind of, like, what kind of things are you looking for there? Cause, or do you just, do you already know before the actual performance who's going to win? Or do you, like, look for certain people and be like, okay, it's down to, like, these five people, and then you leave it up to that? Or what's, like, how does the actual performance come in there?
Because
I'm definitely thinking back to Calgary 2 years ago, and because I think everyone in, like, I think everyone in the journeyman category except for one had a skit, so it was a little ridiculous.
For how it has been every single time that I've judged, which is only three times, generally we'll do like the pre-judging, and then we'll talk about it amongst ourselves, the judges, like, all right, so these are our three that we think are doing like the best in our minds right now or whatever, and then the stage part comes and we're like, well, son of a bitch, now we got to rethink everything, because
right.
The stage portion is like, it's half of what we're judging you on, right? So I don't know. I guess it's hard to describe, but yeah, every single time that I've gone, we've had like, all right, here's our shortlist, and then immediately like, all right, we'll throw that shortlist out the window because this person just played a game changer.
Right. So then, does, like, how do you feel about, like, I guess performances being judged in like a cosplay, like, I guess there's that difference between like performance and craftsmanship, I suppose, if that's how I had to kind of explain it.
Okay. I mean, craftsmanship is pretty clear cut. It's like how well things were built and yada yada yada. That's like a easily quantifiable, I guess, sort of thing. You know? Performance, I always go by how amped you're getting the crowd, or how excited the crowd seems.
Right.
Your performance last year at FanCon was a great example, because I got like goosebumps, and I was like, okay, that's a good thing. I'm gonna write down that I got goosebumps on this skit. That's one of my criteria now. Did I get goosebumps?
And I mean, like, that, like, that's one of the things that, like, I knowingly went into that. And I mean, at some point, like, I don't know, I might end up doing like a panel on like cosplay skits. It's like, I'm really pushing for skits this year. That's what I really want, especially at Prince George. But
that's a good one.
Yeah, like that was one of the things, and maybe I'll do a video on it. I don't know, figure it out. But like, one of the things that I, like, I know, I'm like, okay, I want the crowd reaction. You kind of base it around it type thing.
Yeah.
So if anyone's actually, you know, thinking of it, like, I've seen people win awards as walk-ons, and it happens. It happens far less than people with skits or even a monologue, or, you know, hell, even them just bringing in their own music from the game. You know, if you're wearing like a League of Legends armor and you're just kind of walking on with the generic K-pop song, it kind of loses that, I don't know, it kind of loses that presence and that sort of, that impact type thing.
Yeah, so presence, maybe, is a good way to put it, for sure. If someone has a lot of presence, that goes a long way.
Mm-hmm. And definitely, like, you know, get your butt downstage. Like, get to the front and get, like, kind of right in the audience's face type thing, and really, like, you know, let them see and let you kind of amplify it. Show the back, all that good stuff. Yeah, I'm totally going to have to make a video on this stuff. I'll do that. I'm gonna write that down.
I always judge, there'll be the pre-judging, and I can't, first year when I was judging at Calgary, what's her cosplay page name? Autumn Cosplay?
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, we met her, doing the pre-judging, and Negri had to go to the bathroom, so she had to actually kill, like, 10, 12 minutes with us or something. Well,
oh, really?
So we're just chilling there, taking, like, photos or whatever.
What the hell is taking Jessica Negri 10 minutes in the bathroom? I hope you, like, slammed her on that.
Well, no, because the bathroom wasn't in the pre-judging room. You had to go, like, all the way, right? And then it's Negri, so, like, every 10 feet. Like, hey, can I get a photo?
probably happened in the bathroom, too.
It's probably. Like,
guys,
but, anyway, enough about Negri in the bathroom. I'm sorry.
Yeah, sorry, everybody.
Anyways, Autumn Cosplay, really, really awesome girl. But she's like this little, like, quiet, shy girl, and she's awesome. And then on stage, she just like brought out like this inner beast. Well, okay, it was like a she was Hero from Big Hero 6, and she did like a whole little skit thing there. But like the difference between like the backstage person and the onstage person was like night and day, like comparative to like a small, like quiet girl to just like owning yourself on stage. And that she was my runner up choice. So that was like the whole reason. It was just like, wow, she was so also her costume was great, but she was so confident up there that I was like, oh yeah, she's getting my vote.
So the big thing you're saying is like, hey, like that performance, get up there type thing, and really give that your all, almost more than the costume type thing.
Yeah, definitely.
And like, yeah, I totally agree with that. It's like you're leaving an impact at that point. You're just kind of like, oh, like, because like you say, it's, oh, I need to reconsider this person because wow, like.
Mm-hmm. Well, because it's hard to tell. Like if you're talking to your friends about a cosplay contest, it's one thing to tell them, like, I guess, without showing them a picture. If you had to describe to them some cosplays, you would be like, oh, that was really cool, it was really big, and it was like Batman. But the performances are way easier to talk about and like emote about how you feel. Like, oh yeah, he walked around, he did this motion, and got the crowd all amped. It's a lot easier to articulate a performance than just a static piece of like of cosplay.
Right. What about the people that like are like stupidly nerve? Like, I mean, I know people that have been cosplaying for like 3 years and getting judged for like, you know, at 2 or 3 conventions every year for 3 years, and they're still nervous going into that room. Like, how do you, like, what can you, I don't know, what kind of advice can you give to those people to kind of, I guess, calm the nerves a little bit?
What's good advice? Well, everyone there, there's nobody has like any like throwing utensils in the crowd for one.
No, I mean more like the prejudging thing, but yeah, I guess true.
What was your question? Rephrase your question. I got lost.
So like, okay, I'm like, this is my first or my second cosplay contest, and I gotta go in for prejudging. So I'm standing in this line for like 20 minutes. I'm seeing all these people with costumes that I'm like, oh my god, these people are so much better than me, and now I have to go and meet like these celebrity cosplayers. And, you know, you're just nervous and sweating, and you just kind of want to sit down, huddle up, and throw up like your cat type thing. Like, what would be your advice to those people to kind of, you know, calm the nerves down and actually, you know, get them in there type thing?
I gotcha. Well, I guess there's a few pieces of advice here. Thankfully, most cosplay lines are pretty long. So that means you can talk to some of those people that are scaring you, and I'm just, you know, you can talk to them, find out that they're actually humans and they're not just like little gods of foam and cloth.
They're probably scared too.
They're probably just as scared, if not more scared than you. You gotta remember that you're at a comic convention, and comic conventions are like a safe haven for like the anxious and nerdy types, right? So we're all like the same type of person there. The other thing is that, because I do a lot of art, I do a lot of drawing and stuff. So I'll draw something like, wow, this looks like crap, and then some people will walk by and like, hey, that looks really great. You're always going to see the flaws in what you're making like 100 times better than anybody else. Isn't that right, my girlfriend Chantel, who makes costumes as well?
I was not listening.
She doesn't listen to me.
Perfect. Chantel, just agree and say, yes, honey.
Sure.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah, see, we have confirmation. What are you making right now, anyway?
Jacket.
She's making a jacket.
Great.
Badly.
Boy, why didn't I interview you with fantastic dialogue? Like,
look at all this foam back here.
Oh god, foam.
But yeah, you're always going to see the flaws in your own stuff way more. So take heart in the fact that you built something by hand, and you're wearing it like out in the open. That's my favorite thing at cosplay contest is seeing like the first comers there. I remember my first convention, like walking out onto the streets, and you're just like so nervous before you get to the con because it was in Vancouver. So you're like walking across down the street, like I look like an absolute jackass, yeah. And then you see like this herd of your people. Like, I need to get in there, and then as soon as you're in there,
please,
you say,
please,
please take me. Just remember that feeling.
It's always fun on the LRT, especially if you go down to Calgary, because I'll stay with friends on like the farthest end possible. And I'm like, cool, I've got a 40-minute train ride. I'm just kind of sitting there. With like pauldrons and a staff, and it's like, sup? Then one person gets on finally, like, oh, thank god. They're wearing power armor. I don't look like the biggest weirdo here.
I look less weird now, please.
Yes. Like, second weirdest person on the bus. Oh, yes.
It's the worst being in big armor, getting onto the train. Like, it's okay if you're far away from the con, but like when you're like close to the con, it's like, oh, this train's like 3/4 full. There's no room for me.
Yeah.
Be like a jackass. Like, can you get your baby out of the way? I need to put my arm there.
Oh man, I'm just imagining you turning by accident, just clocking a kid by accident.
Oh, I've done it. Many
oh, times. Have you?
Yeah, you don't realize how like wide how your brain like automatically calculates how wide you are when you're walking somewhere until you're wearing something that's like a foot wider on each side. Then you're just like bonk, oh that's a person, bonk, that's a table.
Have you done the like walking dunk on the like top of a door or something like that? Yes.
Not yet. I've never been that tall yet.
I'm waiting for that. That'll be pretty fantastically exciting, I think. So I don't know. Any other last like little bits of things now that I've talked to you for like half an hour or so? Like, because I just want to see more people get more comfortable and like, I know some ask like, well, what are the secrets? What should I know? And like, there's not really. I don't know about you. Like, there's not really much secrets. Like. I mean, the rubrics, the marking sheets that I've always had of being like, you know, and like you say, I don't even really look at them. I'm kind of like, okay, yeah, here are, like, I want the top six when I'm usually looking, and then I'll, like, write down notes on that, or, like, and sometimes it's the top four, and sometimes it's the top 10, or whatever. But yeah, it's usually, like, construction, materials, what else was on there? I'm trying to think of, like, the non-present stuff.
Oh, what was the one that was on there? It was closeness to the character was one?
Yes, yeah. Closeness or originality or something.
Originality, it's like...
Cause it's hard, because sometimes it's like, hey, I made this costume that's a mashup of this. Like, well, I don't know. How's that matching the character that doesn't make sense? Like,
It's a little hard. I think that's a lot of problems with when people are like really nervous in line. They're like, my costume doesn't look anything like the character. It's like, well, there's a good chance that... The cosplay judge might not know what fandom this is from, because I'm like not a huge anime head. I watch a little bit, but like anytime someone comes up, I'm like, I can tell what Attack on Titan is. I just don't know all the minutia of details in the jacket or anything.
You're the short blonde one, yeah.
So like, don't feel bad about like, oh, this isn't exactly like it is on screen, because there's like a 900% chance that we can't recall every single detail on every costume in all the world. So don't bring it up. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I guess that's one thing. Yeah, like don't go up there and be like, all right, tell us what your costume. Well, I didn't have this or this, and I don't like. Okay, like just tell us what's there. Like,
tell us.
I know the question that I usually ask is usually like, what was the hardest, like the hardest thing for you to do on the costume? Because like I want to know, like I really want to see people kind of do something like different or challenge themselves and be like, you know, like. Everyone that's wearing it clearly managed to get around it. It's like, how did you do this? Oh my god, I had like, I think my thing was, because you wouldn't have judged me last year, but when I was making like my hawk belt, I'm using like real fur and all this and wax thread and it's pulling and I'm like, you know, it's like, well, you know, like that was the hardest thing for me. How'd you get by it? I used KY jelly to lubricate the wax thread. And then like the one judge there, it's leather. It's like ah yes, you learned that trick. I'm like, okay, I just kind of had it sitting around.
Or it's Ben's cosplay mustard. That's the other one. That's my favorite.
Oh yeah, for like the not rust, but yeah,
for weathering grease. And stuff.
Well, and it's like that's I don't know. To me, like that's what I love most about judging is that you hear about all these like you did what like. Use a strainer? Like
it's true. You get a lot of weird tips and stuff out of judging. I've learned more from judging than I ever did just trying to learn how to cosplay.
Oh, by far. That's kind of why I like it. Like, even, you know, like, I'll be judging novices that it's, like, their first cosplay, like, you know, their first costume, and they'll tell me something like, son of a bitch, that's a good idea. Like,
and it's usually so simple. You're like, oh my god, I'm so stupid.
Yeah. It's like, that's dumb. I should have known that.
That would have made my life five times easier. Yeah.
That would have saved me 10 hours and $50.
This person is not going to win now. Screw them.
Any other questions that like that you've heard judges ask or that? Just to kind of, I guess, prepare people for what might be asked of them.
Let's see here. How long did it take? What's your favorite parts? Mobility? Those are the main ones, and everything else is just like a sub question within there, really.
Yeah. what did, yeah, how did you do the chainmail if you're using that or stuff like that. So
yeah. I guess a great tip would be to the day before or something, just go over, if you take pictures while you're building, if you're one of those smart people that do that, not me. But
I have a book and a Facebook page.
If you do that, go through it the day before the convention and take a look just so you can remember how you built everything, and maybe just, you know, just quiz yourself. Like, oh, this is, my boots are made out of foam, this is made out of this, this is made out of this. Just go through it a couple times so that when they ask you, you're not like, I made it out of stuff.
Yeah.
That was there.
I know when I was, 2 years ago when I was in Calgary, me and Tash were right beside each other type thing, and we're like in the lineup, and even like the night before in the hotel, but like even right at the lineup, we're like, okay, I use this for this, I use this, like kind of running it down, just because it's like, I know I'm going to forget to mention 60% of what I'm saying right now, but hey, like at least I'm remembering the 40. Like,
that's true.
What do you want? What are you meowing about?
They don't want to hear everything about your costume because they don't have the time. Keep it short and simple. Yeah.
Look at that. My cat's not throwing up. Don't you dare. Hello, Rija.
Now that would be great.
Yeah, that'd be, yeah, that'd just be fantastic. All over the window like that.
Yep. Yum.
Any, like, last-minute things? Advice for people?
Just do it. Just go out there and cosplay. Be a big dork.
That's about it. And then people can find you where? Links and all that, and I don't know, on your face or something.
Bronskin Cosplay Tattoos and Doodles, and you can find most or a bunch of my tattoo work on my shop page that I my boss's shop page, Twisted and Tortured Inkworks. If you want a tattoo that's super nerdy and ridiculous, come to Williams Lake. Don't stay though, just get the tattoo. Don't cut that part out, because I'm sure I'll get a lot of people from Williams Lake just ragging on me.
I mean, whatever. It's only like 30 people that will rag on you anyway. So
that's fair.
Whatever, are you judging in PG this year? I don't even know.
I'm not sure. I asked Norm. He's gonna let me know. So, last year it was like
Norm. If you're watching this,
last year I didn't know until like the day of. I was like, I don't know if I'm judging. And Norm came by. Hey, you're judging, right? I'm like, okay, yep.
All right,
here I go. it'll be fun. Either way, it's gonna be fun.
Yeah, and I know we've got some like cool Hollywood actual movie costume creators and that are going to be there, which is like, wow, I'm intimidated because you actually know what you're talking about. I just throw things together and like, I guess this is a top stitch? I don't know.
It's one of the wiggly ones, yeah? It's a wiggle stitch.
Yeah, it's a zip. I'm not even going to talk about how I'm making that sport coat and how I just kind of like, I'll just put this here somehow. Pins. No one will notice.
It's got to be hard with a sport coat, because like with foam, it's like, oh, I cut something crappily. It's battle damage!
Not a whole lot of battle damage on a sport coat, but whatever, I'm making it work, it's fine. It's my first time using a pattern, and I'm like, how does a sleeve do this? Anyways, we could talk for a while, but I should let you go, and then, I will send people your way. There'll be links in the description. If there's other things I can, now that I've taught Bronson how to actually use Skype and all that wonderful stuff, if there's like another video, if you manage to actually get through 40 minutes of us just talking at each other, let me know, put a message below, do all the Sherry stuff, and I can bug him about whatever. You haven't retired your Gypsy Danger yet, have you?
You want to know where it is? It's hilarious.
Oh God. Yes.
So Gypsy Danger is a big costume, and I built a big huge Batman costume as well, like a big huge armored one, and I started building a big huge armored Superman. I'm like, all right, this is ridiculous. My tiny 2-bedroom apartment is not big enough for all these costumes. I gotta get rid of it. So
Did you repurpose it?
No, I didn't repurpose it, don't worry. I was thinking about getting rid of it. I talked to my mom, who not recently now, she's owned it for like a year or so, but she bought a quilt store in 100 Mile. And she's like, you know what? If I could display it in my quilt store. If you guys ever check out Dancing Quilt in 100 Mile, there's like, it's like on this mannequin that's too small for it. So it's like all like, got like the boat in her hands.
Oh my God.
My mom, none of the old ladies there know what it's from. So they all call it the quilting police to make sure that your blades aren't left out when you leave the table. Wow. It's really awesome.
That's what happened with that movie. You know, it's just a bunch of robots stopping, you know, 6-year-olds from leaving blades out. Yeah.
They're the danger. I'll send you a picture of it. It's really funny.
Oh, please do. All right, yeah, but yeah, let me know if there's questions. I'll bother you, and you're gonna do some goofy, stupid video and some garbage '90s rap thing at Calgary, anyways. I'm sure.
Damn straight.
Yeah, look forward to it. Did you see our pictures from our makeout session as The Last of Us?
Yes, those were great. I need to share them on my page. Actually, I keep forgetting to.
Yeah, I know. I gotta get back into that a little bit more. I have to get some print. Ugh, stupid. Whatever. Yeah. If you have questions, I can bug Bronson again. Ask me below, and we will talk for another like half hour or so. And yeah, should be fun. Thanks a lot, Bronson. Chantel, bye. Finish your jacket. Clean up your cat puke. I'll see you guys in like a week or however many. What is it, a month? I don't even know. I'll see you in Calgary whenever the hell I'm actually there.
Yeah, it's like 25 days or something like that.
Dear Lord, okay.
Yeah, gotta go. Bye.
I have to go do work. Bye. See ya. Well, here's a list of things that I have screwed up in my years of cosplaying. I actually have a watch. She threw up in my pajamas pocket once.
In your pajamas pocket, hey?
In the pocket, yeah. Like, I went to, like, oh, good, I'll put my pajama pants on. And you know how you, like, put your hands in the pockets to kind of, like, smooth things out? And you're like, oh, what's that? I'm like, oh. And then she did it again, like, 3 weeks later. I'm like, why inside the pocket?
Like, it's not a trick not that on I would the use thing. Her.
God, it's like, that's just where it's spiteful. Like, I don't know, I feel like... I don't even know what I threw at her. It's part of an elastic.